Today we commemorate International Albinism Awareness Day, a day chosen by the General Assembly 5 years ago to celebrate people with albinism around the world. It is also a day to stand in solidarity with people with albinism in their successes as well as their challenges. In this unprecedented time with the COVID-19 pandemic, people with albinism are more vulnerable to human rights violations. There are reports of persons with albinism being branded Corona and COVID-19 in some countries, effectively labeling them scapegoats of the pandemic and further ostracizing them in their communities. In some countries, persons with albinism also suffer violent attacks and killings. This is due to harmful superstitions and false beliefs that their body parts can bring good luck. Women and children often bear the brunt of those atrocities. I urge governments to be vigilant against these violations and to ensure strong protection measures for people with albinism. Failure to destigmatize albinism, address racial discrimination, and accommodate visual impairment combined with bullying and risk of attacks often results in a large number of students with albinism dropping out of school. This in turn leads to unemployment and a life of poverty. I call on all relevant governments to ensure that the human rights of people with albinism are included in the measures and decisions aimed at eliminating socioeconomic disparities, particularly during the pandemic. I also urge the authorities to ensure that people with albinism have access to health and education services without discrimination. Notwithstanding these situations, we have seen positive developments over the years. National task forces on albinism composed of multi-sectoral actors have been established in various countries in Africa, a region where attacks against people with albinism occur. The first ever regional action plan on albinism was adopted by the African Union as a continent-wide policy in July 2019. We're also seeing a significant increase in activists and civil society organizations representing persons with albinism around the world. However, many of them are in dire need of resources and technical assistance. I call on member states and the international community to build and strengthen partnerships with these groups as a concrete way to accelerate social inclusion and promote respect for human rights. As the 2030 Sustainable Development Agenda promises that no one be left behind, today we stand together with people with albinism all over the world in their fight to live a life that is free of stigma, discrimination, fear, and violence. I wish you all well on this International Albinism Awareness Day.